Welcome back, everybody. You are still watching The Lowdown. I'm James Donner. I still got my good friend, comedian Tommy Vallone, but we are joined by social media coach Max B in the house. Yes! Max coach B. Max! Now, I got to tell you, people at home are just like me, because when I first heard that we had Max coming on, I was looking for a dude, and you are not a dude.
No, I'm not.
No, I checked. You are not. Yeah. No, but thank you so much for being here with
us. Yes, I'm awesome. So happy to be here.
I'm glad. Now, you are a social media coach, but you don't just do that. You do a lot of different things.
Yes, I do. So I do a lot of teaching of how to start a business, financial literacy, maintain your money, and invest it to make more money.
I love it. So you tell people how to start it, how to maintain it, how to keep it, then how to get the word out.
Yes.
Okay, that's good. See what I just did? I marketed that. You owe me $5.
I've actually got $4.1 million.
And a billboard.
You definitely need to call me. Yeah.
Now, I'm dying to know a little bit about how you got started. Now, how did you get into what you do?
Wow. So, you know, my journey started basically from being in so much debt from having student loans.
Oh, so you went to school.
Went to school.
You said, hey, I'm going to get a better living by going to school, doing the right things.
Right.
But then you came out and you were just in debt.
In debt. So, you know, just like everybody else's parents, go to school, get a job.
Yeah.
Go out there in corporate America. But little did I know, I came into corporate America very young.
Okay.
At 21. And
that is young. Very young.
It was like, hold on, they're not about to hire you for this awesome job. That did not happen.
No.
At all.
The promise that they gave you, you get this education, you're going to get this fantastic job when you get out, and that didn't happen.
That didn't happen.
Gotcha.
No, so I had to go on a journey, so I went on Google University, as I call it.
Okay.
Got on my computer, and I started looking up how to make extra money online.
Gotcha.
And I came into this thing like, start a business.
Mm-hmm.
So I came into it, and I got on social media, and I started learning all of the wonderful things about Facebook and Instagram.
That's right.
And what it can do for a business.
Gotcha.
And then at that point, I got a mentor, because I was like, okay, I got stuck. I was like, okay, what do I do from here?
How do I proceed?
How do I proceed?
I've hit a ceiling. How do I keep
going?
Right.
When I got a mentor, that's when my life changed. And essentially, I set out and I put it out there that I wanted to teach other people how to do the same thing.
Gotcha. So once you achieve your goal, you're like, I want to help people who are in the same boat I was in.
I was in,
to get out of it.
Exactly.
Gotcha. So I assume you're all out of your student loan debt?
Yes.
Gotcha. That's a better idea what you did, you know, learning business than my idea, because I was going to burn my college down. But no, that's...
I thought about it a few times, too.
And people don't know that social media has a lot of power.
A lot.
It really does. I mean, come on. If Facebook worked for the Russians, think about what it could do for us.
That is hilarious. Yes.
Now, you're a full-time mentor and business coach
full-time.
Under the age of 30. Now, I'm not going to ask you your age because that's rude. But I will ask you how much you weigh.
That's even more rude.
I know. I'm joking. Now, walk me through a day, like going through what you do.
Going through a day. So I will tell you my age. I'm 27, and I've been full-time for 5 years.
Amazing.
Wow.
And a day, I get up, I go to the gym, and then I come
from
the gym.
That's one thing that we don't do is the same. Okay, go ahead. I mean, I know a dude.
I go to the gym, and then after that, I'm pretty much on my computer working with my clients till about 5 p.m.
Gotcha.
At that point, I go pick up my daughter and have family time. So,
gotcha.
Being a full-time entrepreneur is definitely a different lifestyle than most people.
So you keep going. There is no off day, so to speak. There is no
Sunday.
Sunday usually, okay. Oh, well, Chick-fil-A's off. Okay, I get. Why get out of bed? Okay, so what does your Elevation Agency do exactly? Because I know that's what you work out of.
So the Elevation Agency, what we do is we take someone from absolute debt, and I walk them through four phases.
Gotcha.
So the first phase is that we're going to fix your credit, and we're also going to work on your mindset. Because a lot of people believe that they cannot have more.
Talk about that.
The mindset is so important.
It is. For you to be, here's what happens. People want things, but they're not willing to make the sacrifice to get it. Because what people want you to tell them, I bet, is tell me how to save money while I still get to spend money.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah. So we work on mindset. When I say mindset, that's exactly what I'm talking about, financial discipline. So you have to
discipline.
It's hard,
mm-hmm.
you know, but I had to do that. I was 6 figures in student loan debt. So it's like, do I continue having a good time on the weekend, or do I sacrifice that time to save?
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? So I teach those principles to my students inside the Elevation Agency. The second thing is we work on credit. You have so to get important. Your credit together. If you want to be a homeowner, if you want to have a good, you know, car with not those high interest rates, things like that, you have to get that credit fixed.
And talk to people about credit, because yeah. listen to me, my people at home. Yeah. Fixing your credit doesn't mean putting your light bill in your mama's name. That is not. But really, what's an easy first step to working on your credit?
A lot of people don't even know to go look at their credit because nobody's telling them.
Right. They don't
first
know the
of
score.
All, let's go find the score.
I can't work on the problem so I know what it is.
Exactly. So yeah. let's go find the score. Mm-hmm. Okay. Once we find the score, from there, we need to see, is there anything on this credit report that is inaccurate?
Got you.
Okay, because sometimes there might be things wow. being reported that you just don't even know, that don't even belong to you. A yes. lot of my clients run into that problem. Once we find what's incorrect, we write a few letters to the bureau and get those things deleted. Mm-hmm. Once we get them wow. deleted, that score goes up. The second thing that someone can do is they can get a credit card and use it properly.
Not just because I want it,
not
I'm going to get it.
I want it, but the creditors and the lenders want to see that you're responsible.
That's right.
Okay, they want to see that you're able to use this money wisely.
Yes.
That's why we work on phase one, which is financial discipline.
And you should only be using credit cards in cases of emergencies.
Emergency, exactly.
And ladies, Louis Vuitton is not an emergency.
No, it's not.
It's not. Yes.
So when we get credit fixed, the third thing that we do is we look for investments. So
yes.
you can either start a business or you can put your money somewhere that it'll grow.
But you got to make your money work for you.
You have to make it work for you.
Gotcha.
Yeah. So, and then from there, life is good.
There you go. You're smiling, so it must be.
Yes.
Now, so inside Lit Academy, what can a potential student expect from you when you're teaching them?
I'm not an easy coach.
Are you really?
No.
Wait, so you're saying there's women that are not easy to talk to? Surely you jest. Surely.
No, I am not an easy coach. My students would say
you're not easy on people.
No.
Okay.
Because it's like, you know, do you want me to hold your hand and baby you, or do you want me to hold you accountable so that your finances can get better?
Gotcha.
You know, so I hold them accountable. I make them work on their mindset every day. So that means read a book about money. You know, I love Forbes. Go on Forbes and see what's going on in our economy today, things like that. I make them spread themselves, you know, stretch themselves. Right?
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Now, I definitely want people to be able to reach out to you, because the message yes. you're giving, we talked so much before this, is amazing.
Thank you.
So tell them where yeah. they can reach you on social media.
So you can reach me at CoachMax_ on Instagram is where I like to be the most, or you can contact me on theelevationagency.com.
You got Carmen. You write that in your phone. Can I borrow $5?
Yeah. Okay.
Guys, don't go anywhere, because when we get back, we're going to have more of the Funny Time of the Loan, and we're going to have Coach Max sending us to do some viral videos. We'll be right back on the Loan.